Hello, dear viewers. You are most welcome to Standard High School Zana virtual classroom. What you need to do, visit our YouTube channel at Standard High School Zana. Make sure you subscribe and don't forget to hit the notification bell so that whatever lesson that is uploaded, you can get it instantly. My name is Jonas Gumiserza, a Department of Business here at Standard High School Zana. So today we are going to look at O-level commerce. And this subject is coded 800/1. That is a very big benefit to the learners. This subject has only one paper. So once you pass it, you have passed it. Not like these other subjects where they have to add paper 1, paper 2, paper 3, and they make average. For commerce, once you have passed, you have passed. And this lesson of today will not benefit only the commerce students, but also other business students, like those who do entrepreneurship. Or there may be some businessmen who are watching over there. And today we are going to look at a very familiar topic, a topic that we apply in our daily lives, and that is business calculations. Business calculations. Business calculations. So when you look at this term, has got two words, business and calculations. When we talk of a business, dear learners, we mean any activity that is undertaken in order to make profits. Any activity undertaken in order to make a profit is what we call a business. Then calculations, we mean mathematical expressions that businessmen use in order to determine whether the business is making profits or they are used in making informed decisions in business. So when we combine it and call business calculations, we mean the mathematical expressions that businessmen use to determine whether the business is making profits or not, and they are also used in making business decisions. So we need to see how helpful are these business calculations. Benefits of business calculation. Benefits of business calculations. How helpful are these calculations to a businessman? Number one, they are used to determine whether the business makes profits or losses. When you want to know, are you making profits or losses, you use these business calculations, as we shall see as we move on. Also, these calculations are used to make business decisions. If you want to make a decision whether to invest money in a business or not, you are helped by these calculations. Because these calculations, as we have said in number one, they help to determine whether the business is profitable or not. So depending on that, you can easily make a decision of what step to do next. Also, these business calculations are used for future reference. In future, you can keep referring to these records and maybe call a meeting and ask employees, the other year we made 100 million profit. This year we have made 50. What is the problem? Future reference. Also, they are used by the government in assessment of taxes. So if you are which is a department of the government, the Uganda Revenue Authority, comes to your business to assess how much tax you should pay, they always ask for these records. So dear viewer, those are some of there are many, but these are the main benefits or importances of having business calculations in a business. So dear learners and viewers out there, I must say this. This is a very easy section to attempt, and it can never miss in a final examination. It is always number 28. You enter in the examination room knowing that number 28 is about this and this. So it's a matter of getting prepared for it. And this is a question where you can score 20 out of 20, which is hard on an essay question. But again, it is very easy also to score 0 out of 20. So I normally advise the students that if you read this question and you see you have not understood it very well, please don't attempt. Go for other questions, because on an essay question, it is also hard to get 0. So instead of going on a question and you get 0 out of 0, at least get 5-10 from this essay question. But I must tell you, it is the easiest question to attempt. Now, dear viewers, let's look at terms used in business calculations. And these terms are the ones that we shall be using in the process of doing these numbers, as we shall see when we move on. And number one, we have what we call opening stock. When we talk of opening stock, as you hear its word opening stock, we mean the amount of goods or items that the business starts with at its time of commencement, at its time of starting. In other words, this is starting stock. But however, we need to know that it becomes the starting stock if the business is new, if the business is starting. But for a continuing business, even the stock that remained unsold in the previous period is the opening stock of the current period. So this takes us to another term which we call closing stock. When we talk of closing stock, dear viewers, we mean the amount of goods that remain unsold at the end of a trading period. We have started our business in January with our opening stock. We have worked on 31st December, which is the closing date, we find that there are some goods in the store which we are not able to sell. So that's what we call the closing stop. So in a question, sometimes we don't write opening or closing stock. For opening stock, we normally say stock on 1st January, let's say 2020. So it is up to you to know that businesses start on 1st of January. Then this closing stock, we normally say stock on 31st December 2020. That's how we can also give this information. So you need to be very careful. Then also we have what we call purchases. Purchases are goods or items that are bought during the year for resale. You know, many businesses deal in the buying and selling of goods. So these goods that we buy during the year and they are meant for resale are what we call purchases. Also, from the purchases, we can now introduce another term called the net purchases. So the net purchases are goods that are bought during the year for resale minus the goods that were returned back to the suppliers, which we call the purchases, returns, or the returns outwards. You go to a supplier, order for goods, which we call purchases. But on this, a person delivering the goods, he delivers the goods, some of which you did not want, some of which may be damaged, and you decide to take them back. So when you get the total sum of the purchases minus the goods that were taken back, which we call the returns outwards, it's what we call the net purchases. And these net purchases equals purchases minus returns outwards, or which you can call purchases returns. You have bought the goods, but in the supplier bringing the goods, there comes goods that you never wanted or you had not ordered. Therefore, you have to take them back to get the net figure, the actual figure of the purchases. Also, after looking at that, we have also to look at now what we call the returns outwards. The returns outwards. These are amount of goods that the business had purchased but later returned back to the suppliers. And this is done for various reasons. One, the goods may be expired. The goods may be damaged, or the goods may be wrongly specified. are the main reasons why goods are returned back. One, damage, expiry date, and wrong specifications. See you in the next episode.